So in the next series of lectures, what I was hoping would be useful for you, and you can tell me if it isn't useful, but to group the cranial nerves kind of by their function. So I decided to group the cranial nerves that innervate your extraocular muscles as one set and talk about them all together. They're all motor, there's no sensory components, and they are all projecting to the orbit, the actual area around your eyeball. There are three of them, cranial nerve 3, 4, and 6. And on our rubber brainstem model, we can see 3 here and 4 off to the side, because remember, 4 is the trochlear and it comes around from the dorsal aspect of the brainstem. And we can see 6 here on the midline, or closer to the midline. In the base of the skull, we can see these nerves. Here is cranial nerve 3, because this brainstem would be laying right along here with the ventral surface up against this bony surface here. So here's cranial nerve 3. Cranial nerve 4 is this skinny thing. It's very difficult to see because, like I said, it's coming around the dorsal part of the brainstem. So it kind of gets embedded here in the edge of the tentorum cerebelli as it's coming forward to go towards the eyeball. I would like to point out that this is the roof of the orbit here. And it's a very thin shelf of bone, and just right underneath there is some fat, and the actual optic nerve and the eyeball itself is right under there. Cranial nerve 6 can be seen here, and it's coursing up underneath this piece of dura that lines the base of the skull, and again is heading up here towards the eye. And once you're in the orbit, so now we're in the orbit itself. We've cracked through that bone, and we can see here's the orb. Way deep in here, you can see that really thick structure, which is the optic nerve. And now we can see these nerves. Again, we can see our oculomotor nerve is really large, and it's coming through here and giving off all kinds of branches. We can see, just a little bit of the trochlear nerve here coming in, and it's going to innervate this muscle that's going up and around, which is the superior oblique muscle. And we can see a little bit of the abducens nerve, which is coming around here to innervate the lateral rectus. And we'll go through these a little bit more specifically. I also want to orient you as to that this is, when we talk about the eye, we often don't talk about medial and lateral. We talk about nasal and temporal. So nasal towards your nose side, and that's this side. And temporal is more lateral, and it's towards your temporal bone, and that's out here. One of the reasons I want to introduce you to the way to talking about that when we talk about the eye and the orb is because that is also the way that the visual fields are discussed. They'll talk about your temporal visual field or your nasal visual field. So that's something to kind of think about as you go through learning about neuroscience in the future. The other thing I want to introduce you to is this quote-unquote chemical formula that I have written up here, LR6SO4, and then everything else in parenthesis 3. And what that is supposed to remind me to tell you is that cranial nerve 3 innervates a whole bunch of muscles, the levator palpebrae superioris, the superior rectus, the medial rectus, the inferior rectus, and the inferior oblique. All are innervated by cranial nerve 3. Cranial nerves 4 and 6 each only innervate one muscle. 4 innervates the superior oblique, hence SO4, and 6 only innervates the lateral rectus, lateral rectus 6. So LR6, lateral rectus, 6 cranial nerve, SO4, superior oblique, cranial nerve 4, everything else is cranial nerve 3. And that's the way I remember which of the cranial nerves innervates which of my extraocular muscles. And in the next segment, we'll talk about cranial nerve 3 specifically, and then we'll talk about 4 and 6.